Hey folks, I'm Sam Lewis here with iZotope. I want to show you some of the new features designed for music in the brand new RX11. When you upload music to streaming platforms, there can often be a sense of uncertainty about how your track is going to stand up against others. To give you the confidence in what you're uploading and to optimize your tracks for these platforms, RX11 now has two brand new modules designed specifically to give you that confidence and make sure your track sounds great wherever it's being heard. The first is Streaming Preview. This module allows you to choose from a number of different streaming platforms and model the loudness normalization and lossy encoding that streaming platform will apply. Once you hit render, the resulting file will be exactly what your listeners are hearing on the streaming platform you've selected, so you can have a direct insight into how the platform is going to affect your track. This means that you either know it's going to sound great, or if it doesn't, you can make adjustments to your track, run the process again, and end up with something that you're proud of. And this leads to the second module, which deals directly with loudness. When we think about loudness standards, LUFS, often there's a worry that your music won't stand up or sound as loud or punchy as others on streaming platforms. You've read the guidance, you understand the targets, but still it feels like a grey area. If this is more than a grey area to you, maybe you want the full lowdown on what LUFS actually are, then you can watch this video at the top right now. You can get the information you're missing, and then come back and check out the rest of this video. What a lot of people don't realize about the LUFS standard is that when a track is measured, it may not actually be measuring the entire song. It takes into account the full duration, but there's actually a gate involved that means only the audio above the level of the gate is being measured, and we can make this work to our advantage. By bringing the quieter sections of the track up to be included in the LUFS analysis, so bringing them up above the level of the gate, we're actually bringing the LUFS value down, so when the track is then adjusted by streaming platforms to match whatever their recommended LUFS value is, the track is actually going to be louder. That concept can seem a little counterintuitive. How can making parts of a track louder bring the LUFS value down? Surely by making anything louder, you're raising the LUFS. Well, check out this example. Here I have an audio file loaded into RX. It's just a snare drum sample with a room reverb. Using waveform stats, we can see that the integrated loudness is sitting at minus 29.3 LUFS. Watch what happens when I bring up the gain on the tail of the reverb by 20 dB. It's now sitting at minus 31.8 LUFS. That's a significant change. We've brought the measured loudness down just by bringing the volume of a reverb tail up. You'd assume that bringing up the level of any part of the audio file would result in a higher loudness reading, but that's not necessarily the case. By bringing the level of the reverb tail up, we're bringing it above the level of the gate within the LUFS analysis, so it's considered when loudness is measured. It's really about having a track that's got loud sections and quiet sections, but having those quiet sections included in the analysis. If the quiet sections are too quiet, they won't breach the gate threshold, so won't be taken into account during the analysis. By bringing the quieter sections up so they come through that gate and are included, you're essentially telling the analysis, my track is dynamic. You just didn't see it before because it was too low to be registered. So here, I've given you more information to work with and you can see how dynamic my track actually is, so it can give me a lower reading. So to give you a real world example of this, I've got a track in RX that, if we look at the waveform stats again, is currently sitting at minus 8.2 LUFS. But in Loudness Optimize, we can see that only 86% of this track is actually being measured, because 14% is falling below the threshold of the gate. I can ask Loudness Optimize to learn the loudness profile of the track and suggest settings to apply some processing. This is actually going to be a very surgical upward compressor to the quieter sections of the track to bring them up above the gate threshold. Just to walk you through a little of what you're seeing here, the blue line is loudness over time. So you're seeing loud sections and the quieter sections are grey when they fall below the dotted line. The dotted line is the gate that I mentioned. Anything below that line won't be included in the loudest measurement. The percentage at the top is how much of the track is above that gate and therefore being measured. You can see here that currently only 86% of the track is above the gate, so we're not really supplying the loudness analysis with everything possible. And we can optimize this. When I hit render, it's going to apply the upward compression and result in a lower LUFS reading of minus 8.7 LUFS, with 99% of the track taken into account. The result of this is a louder master, but not through limiting or any kind of peak reduction, leaving you with a track that sits better alongside others in the genre. The streaming platform will level the track to its chosen loudness, but it's starting off quieter, so it won't be reduced as much. Check out these two tracks next to each other. So both are leveled to minus 14 LUFS, but you'll notice that the version we've just processed is actually louder, but with a lower LUFS reading. The quieter intro will be louder due to the surgical upward compression, but the louder sections will be louder as well. The idea with these modules is that you can create your track, you master it to sound great, and so your loudness is right for the genre you're working in. Different genres will vary. Then once you know it sounds great in your DAW, you can bring that track into RX and fine-tune it to give you the assurance that it's going to sound as great as it did in your studio on streaming platforms. RX has always been great at displaying audio in a really intuitive way. We can see a waveform or a spectrogram or blend between how much of each is right for the job at hand. You can also view left and right information separately and even work on multi-channel audio. But in RX 11, we've taken that a step further with the addition of mid-side. You can now view and process your audio in mid-side mode to open up a whole host of different repair functions. It means you can deal with issues only present in the mid-channel or just the side channels individually, so you're not processing a part of the audio that doesn't need work. Check out a couple of examples for how this can help you. Here I have a vocal session with the lead in the center and the backing vocals panned hard left and right. I want to tame some of the breaths using breath control, but they're only an issue in the lead vocal, so I can select just the mid-channel and apply my processing without affecting the sides. I also want to remove some of the reverb from the backing, but keep that center reverb intact. By applying de-reverb to just the side channel, I can tame this reverb, but leave the lead vocal alone.
I chose to be alone now instead.
Similarly, on this drum track, I have a mono snare reverb that's a little too much, but the ambience in the left and right is nice and adds to the overall feel of the track. If I'm processing this in stereo, I could remove the snare reverb with the de-reverb module, but it would also remove some of that ambience. In mid-side mode, this is no longer an issue. Sometimes you need to apply the same kind of processing to the mid and side channel, but a little more in the center channel or a little more in the sides. And this is a really simple way of helping you to achieve that. The Repair Assistant has had a complete interface overhaul to give you better access and more control over the features that are important to you. It's split up into four zones. So for vocals, you have cleanup, tone, DS, and D-clip. Then for instruments, DS is replaced with D-harsh. The simplest way to get great results from the Repair Assistant is just to click the Learn button and let RX work out the best settings for the audio you've loaded in. From there, you can listen to the result, and if your preference is to have a little more denoise or a little more DSing, you can easily fine-tune these parameters to get something that sounds great to you. Check out this vocal with a lot of environmental noise, problems with S's and mouth clicks, and then check out the results.
Calls me rough around the edges. I don't think that it's a compliment. I'm sure he'd rather have a nice girl. I think I'd rather drop dead. And maybe that's the best solution. Cause I would finally shut my mouth. Brought me up at the dinner table. I won't have anything to argue about.
Cleanup, DS and D-Clip will be familiar if you've used Repair Assistant before, but the tone section allows you to apply some subtle EQ into the processing chain to fine-tune your sound. Perhaps the whole thing is a little too bright. You can apply a tilt EQ to smooth out the top end while simultaneously bringing up the lows. If it feels like there's an issue in the mids, then you can switch to the scoop setting and either boost or cut that frequency range. The same is true for the instrument side of the Assistant, where you'll find the cleanup and de-harsh processing is more centered around issues that may arise in the recording on instruments like acoustic guitar. This has instrument-specific repair tools such as D-pick and D-squeak. Music Rebalance has become a mainstay for stem separation and rebalancing, but in RX11 we've taken it a step further with the addition of a sensitivity control. This module has always proudly included every single part of the track being rebalanced. If you separate the stems then play back against the original version, it will be 100% identical, and that's still true. But including a sensitivity control for each stem adds an extra layer of flexibility while still retaining that perfect match to the original. You can think of this as being a way of controlling how much of a certain instrument is considered to be that instrument. So with the vocal, we obviously want all of the voice in that stem, but if we bring the sensitivity down, it's going to narrow the parameters of what it considers to be a vocal. Maybe it won't choose to put the breaths in the vocal stem or some of the reverb. And similarly, when you bring the sensitivity up, it's going to really dig deep and get every last bit of the track that it considers to be associated with the vocal, so all the breaths, reverbs, delays. But importantly, it's not getting rid of that information just because the sensitivity is down. It's just offloading them onto another fader. The track will still be a perfect representation of the original. You just have the ability to make each stem more or less selective over what it considers to be a part of that instrument group. Check it out on this vocal. So what if you're not alright? Cause even when you're feeling fine, you called the perfect time. Pull strings till my life's not mine. I think you did it to yourself. I sure am selfish. Took a lot to come back. Really wish I had. Told me from the playful. If you're in a bathroom, begging for a chance, but... So if you're happy with the separation you have with the sensitivity straight up the middle, great, business as usual. You can export these stems out and do whatever you need to do. But if you feel that one of the stems missed something or included too much perhaps, then you now have an extra layer of precision to zone in on what's really important. It's all about balance. Bringing up all the faders to 100 isn't going to be any different than having them at 50 or 0, because you're not telling the module to be more attentive to one stem over another. You're altering the relative balance, and by adjusting the sensitivity, asking the module to be more or less selective. You still get the same sample perfect representation of your original audio, but just with far more control. You can check out all these new features in the brand new RX11 from iZotope now at iZotope.com, as well as some other improved tools for post-production and more. I'll see you again soon. Take care.